If, like me, you are a creative artistic genius, you may want to make your classes more interactive. In this last little video, I'm going to show you some cool tips and tricks on how you can get the best out of the classroom tools and how you can kind of make your classes just that bit more interesting for your students. So let's get started.
So you can see I have this rather fetching shade of hospital food green. So if I go to my colors, you'll see that these colors are always set and the top one changes. So it's random when you get into class. It gives a bit of variety. Sometimes it's great, you have a nice little color to start with. Sometimes, like today, I've got this disgusting mess. So what can I do about it? Well, I can just change to one of these set colors, but maybe they're not suitable. Maybe I'm working with a document that I, you know, want to contrast with. If I go to my settings here, you'll see this little color button. And now I've got all of the different colors to choose from. So I can go for a nice little orange or a nice purple color, much better. Okay, so that's how we can change our colors. Another little trick that might be useful, let's load a PDF here. All right, I'll use the same one I was always using. All right, so if you have a document and you want to cover something up, you have this little eraser tool. So I can go like this and do the next one, and I can just keep going and try and cover it all up. Well, there's a couple of things I can do about it. First of all, this isn't actually erasing anything. It's putting a white layer, white opaque layer over the top. So if I make a little square like that, I can make this bigger and cover some bigger stuff if I want to. But there's an even easier method. Select color, go to white, go down here to add shapes and do the filled in rectangle. And now I can neatly cover up the words or phrases or sections of the document that I want to cover up. For example, up here, I've got this BBC logo, this like topic, I don't really need that. This could be nice whiteboard space. And then to get rid of it, just click and delete. Okay. So that's a nice way to block off sections of the whiteboard. Another feature which is fantastic is copying and pasting. So I can go to one I prepared earlier. Here I've got a beautiful picture of a bee and I can copy image. However, you copy it, and if I paste, it will upload it into my whiteboard. There we go. So it uploads it as an image. I can move it around and do all the things I can usually do with an image. So let's say your student understands what a bee is, but they don't know what a wasp is. I've got another little picture here. There's a trick I can show you. So I don't want to copy an image. I just want to take a bit of my screen. I can take a screenshot, copy it. Let's do this one. That's copied it to my clipboard. And now I can paste it in here. So how did I do that? I can show you as well, just to show, you know, I can take a chunk of my screen, paste it in. For troubleshooting, like we said in the last video, I can explain to my student that I want them to click on the button here, paste it in, like so, you know, so click here to redo your equipment check, whatever. All right, so how did I do that? On a Mac, it is, and this is ridiculous, command plus control plus shift plus 4. This. So when you have a keyboard, you go like that, and then I can take a screenshot. If you are using a Windows computer, Windows. I don't know. I think it's Windows 10. The most recent Windows, whatever it is, some of my students told me. You can click on window, so that you know the little window symbol, plus shift plus S. That will do the same job. So there they are. Those are the controls. I will put them down below in the video description if you're watching this on YouTube. So, basically what that does is it will you select an area of the screen, like I've been doing, and it copies it to your clipboard. So it doesn't save an image, you know, you don't have to like download and upload. You can just copy and paste. Really, really handy feature. I really love that feature. Okay, next thing I'm gonna show you. All right, let's say I've done a beautiful illustration here of a little guy. I actually do have a degree in fine art, as you can tell. So now I want to move him. So I move him bit by bit, and it's a pain in the ass. And when I reassemble him, the delicate nuance of my original drawing is completely gone. So in that case, it's much easier to drag like this. Now I've got them all as one item, and I can move it together. If I want to release, you can see there's this little thing here. Sometimes you do it accidentally. Now they're all separate again. So yeah, sometimes you might accidentally select two things, you don't want to move them. I can just click down here and it will release them again for me. Another nice little thing I can do for this, let's say I want to give our little guy a nice face. Give him a mustache so that people think he's more beautiful. Okay, and the soul patch, why not? So what I can do is I select this and I can make it smaller and stick it on him. So maybe that's actually too small. So you know what? I'm going to make my original guy bigger and stick the face on top. Okay, so if you want to do drawings, I actually draw a lot in my classes. I'm after unselecting him. There we go. So I draw a lot of my classes, so I actually do use this. It's kind of funny. Kids like this kind of stuff as well. If you have young learners, they like little interactive drawings. They find them silly. And in fact, if you're bad at drawing, they like it better. Okay. For my last trick, I'm going to show you how to get my video here over there into the whiteboard. This is something I've been asked before. How can I get a really big video if I want to show something off? So if you are doing a practical class, if you just want to do something a little bit different from the norm, for example, if you're giving a makeup tutorial, this would be really useful so your student can see the video really big and see what you're doing in detail. First thing I'm going to need is video software. So I've got Photo Booth here. This is nothing fancy. This is just software that comes with every Mac. If you're using a Windows computer, I think Movie Maker might do it. Anything that will just show your face, show your video feed from the webcam. If you have a fancy computer, you might be able to actually do two webcams. So you could have your camera here, your normal webcam, and you could use an external webcam on a USB and put that in the whiteboard. So if you've got a really fancy setup, you might be able to have two videos going at the same time. For most of us though, we're gonna have to disable one of them. So let's go to settings, change camera, disable, and then click change. So this camera is now disabled and the other video is gonna work. All right, so I've got it here on my photo booth, that's me. All right, so next thing I do, I go to screen share. You can see I've set it onto high definition. So you can see my beautiful face. And let's go to start sharing, choose the application window, photo booth, which is the one I'm using. And ta-da, okay, here we are. Okay, so as I said, if you want to do a makeup tutorial, this is really, really useful because you can zoom in, I can see the products in great detail. I can see exactly how I'm applying my makeup or whatever you're doing. You could also do this, for example, I mean, I'm a language teacher, I always think in terms of that. If you want to give a little tour of your apartment or your office, you can, you know, point to things and ask what they are. If you are doing, kind of a corporate training and you've got some products that maybe your learners need to interact with, then, you know, it's a really useful trick. And yeah, as I said, sometimes it's nice to shake up the classes and do something interesting. So I hope that you found that useful. And yeah, this is the last video in my little tutorial playlist. So Hope you found all of them useful. As always, if you have any comments or questions, you can put them in the YouTube comments down below if you're watching us on YouTube. Or, of course, don't be afraid to come to learncube.com, and our support team is there to help you if you have any more questions. So happy teaching, and I'll speak to you soon.